Praise God. Sino tinaragsak nga na toy tatakakamsat? Shout hallelujah! Man, pangriing lang kada kayo kakamsat ha. Medyo at dati makita kita nga ha, kung kunanataan. Ito muna ta. Amok nga nabanog kayo nga nag-praise and worship. O reman hanyo ilibak. Taura siya kat nabanogak. Ngem, amin tayo amok nga narik na tayo ti presensya ti Apo. So, tanuan tayo bayag kakabsat? Nabitak lang kakabsat nga agmensahe. Hamot nga abutan iti may sa oras, so nga don't worry. So handak turturugan ah? Please lang, handak turturugan. So, titema tayo tatakabsat, rebuilding your wall. Ito yung latan. Diyak ko na yung mga basa ajay. Kasla gamin ti panagkitak ti Rabi kakabsat, ada ti twinkle, na twinkle twinkle star na no ada yun. So nga, ito yung ayun ti asidag. So, rebuilding your wall. Ayan ti Nehemiah chapter 1 to chapter 6 to 16. Hangko nga basaan adi buunan. Ngam, ibagak iti content na latta na to yung kakabsat. Taabutan tayo ingga na alas 12 no basaan tayo amin na to. So before we proceed, let us pray. Heavenly Father, we thank you, Lord. Ti detoy Apo Diyos nga gundaway. Datoy Apo ti anak mo nga nakatakder, Lord God, nga mangiwaragawag ti sasaong. Lord, i-open mo man iti puso kan ti panunot iti bawat may isa. Kadawatan mi, nga dagito nga sasaom, iso ti ikabil mo Apo, tanu pabiyagan mi, itinaldaw aldaw, kat maidaydayaw ka, babaan Apo, iti dagito'y nga sasaom. And Lord, we declared victory, Lord. You are free to move in this place, Lord God. Kat siyad Apo, ti maidayaw, may tanok, in Jesus' name, Amen. Amen. So, ti content na ato kakabsat, and ti Nehemiah chapter 1, to chapter 6, verse 16, it is the rebuilding the wall of Jerusalem. Rebuilding. Sino timi akin familiar ito yung istorya? Amo ka dagiti pa pastor, familiar na ito. Rebuilding the wall of Jerusalem. Nubasaan tayo, ayun ti Jeremiah, aduti palagtalagtaw na ato yung kakabsat nga book. So nga medyo atidog. Ito ay anti, after the war between the Israelites and Babylonians, the city walls of Jerusalem were broken down and the city was defenseless. As the group of prophet Isaiah prophesied. And the book of Isaiah, kakabsat, na i-prophesy ito'y starting from chapter 40 to 66, iti mangyari iti Israelites. Oh. And ito'y nga time, kakabsat, it is dakkel nga war between the northern kingdom and the southern kingdom of Israel. Bailadtoy, ayan ti time ni Isaiah. But then, ana, in prophesy, iti group ni Prophet Isaiah that the city walls of Jerusalem were broken down and the city was defenseless. Sino timang gubat? The Babylonians. And after 70 years of captivity, the Persian Empire arose and defeated the Babylonian Empire as the group of Prophet Isaiah prophesied. Oh. And then, the Israelites became part of the Persian Empire. Nehemiah obtained permission from the king of Persia to rebuild the walls of Jerusalem. Iso ato'y kabsat, iti kabuuan na ijay ayanti scripture tayo tata. Rebuilding the wall, rebuilding your wall. So, adati question ko. Why do we need a revival? Apay, nga kasapulan tayo nga ma-revive. Example tayo, iti nangyari iti city, wall of Jerusalem. What will happen no handa nga in rebuild aji wall? Awan iti protection. Awan iti protection. So we need a revival so that we need to fix what was broken. Sino ti da magtata? Who among you is broken right now? Sino da giti broken? Ni Sister Chrismel, broken? Huh. Baka katiam mo tayo, no? Gaputa, broken ko na tayo, it's only the heart. No. No, haan lang nga about heart or about love life. But then, because of problems, no, ape nga ma-broken tayo. Sino tutid na problema na? Ne? Basit kam lang? Basit kam lang? Or trials, because of trials. Nagitisag sa gaba, sino tiyad natisag sa gabaon na? Ni, manmano kam lang. Hanyon sa amot kailangan ti revival. Joke lang. Sufferings. Love. Nagititi pagkayatan, nagiti agtutubo ko. Broken hearted. Ano pa? Financial. Financially broken. Oh, amen. Ano pa'y material things? Dagiti material things. Ano pa'y illness? Dagito'y kakabsat, iti pakabrokenan, iti may isa nga tao. Problems, trials, sufferings, love, financial, material things, illness. Now, who among you is broken right now? Shout, amen. Amok. So, iso nga imaten tayo ditoy because we want revival, right? Amo yung kakabsat. The first one nga ma-broken iti unig ti church is the pastors. Man. Your pastors. Apay. Gasum, example, 50 iti miyembro na. 50 ti problema na. What I mean, no na ti problema di may isang miyembro na, problema na mat. Right? Pastors, hamu, dagiti pa pastor, handa makita, handa kayat nga makita, nga dagiti miyembro da, ket madown. O, example lang aja, may isang miyembro, may isang problema. Ket do alang tayo, iti may isang miyembro, ket sanga pulo, ti problema na. Mano problema ni pastor? 10 times 50, 500. Pera pa itay personal problem ni pastor. So, the first one who need to be revived in the church is the pastors, right? So, hanga ito kahit kung ipakita nga, even pastors are not exempted to be broken. So, amin tayo. So, we need revival. So, rebuild your wall. Rebuild your wall. If you want to be revived, then rebuild your wall. Because wall, when you receive Jesus Christ in your life, ne, timayab tay, timayab jidina. He build a wall around you. Idirinisip mo ni Apo Jesus nga Diyos mo na nga ramid isunan iti pader itaglawlaw mo. Apay, because wall represents the presence of God and the presence of God represents fullness in everything. fullness, adadjay ti protection, adadjay ti guidance, anap ay, adadjay aminun. Because God is omnipotent, God is omniscient, and God is omnipresent. So there is fullness in everything. So Christians should rebuild their wall when they were broken. Masapul. Hantay nga bebean, no, broken tayo. Hantay bebean nga ijay tayo latan. Masapul nga i-rebuild tayo. Aji wall nga inpalawlaw ni Apo. Kada tayo. So, sino makaamo iti acronym iti FEAR. F-E-A-R. R. F-E-A-R. FEAR. Anyone? Anyone? Oh. Agpili kayo. Face everything and rise. Hangad rise nga in na po'y ah. Rise. Tumakder. Or face fear. Forget. Sorry, sir. Forget everything and run. Ano kaya tiyo? Face everything and rise. Or forget everything and run. Siyempre, tay umuno na. So, that is how we will build our wall. So, there are ways to rebuild your wall. Ways. Kaya matanahan ka sa 3 pointers na lang. There are ways to rebuild your wall. First, pakibasa. Believe that God is control. Nagita sa gabaong tata, nagita problemam tata. Mamati ka nga ni Apo iti mangkon control. Kanda kita. Alam ko na 20 na Himayat 2, chapter 2, verses 1 to 8. No, basahan tayo kakabsat ayan, the last verse na, ada yung baga natoy ko na natoy. And because the gracious hand of my God was upon me, the King granted my request. Ito'y makita tayo kakabsat, nga ni Apo at the Kenyana ikti control. Because, kunan na to ni, the gracious hand of my God was upon me. Kuna ni Nehemiah. Ta atoy nga time kakabsat, dinamag ni King Artaxerxes no apay nga lonely isuna. And then, imbaga na, kasanunak na balin nga lonely. King, kuna na, kat iti city nga nakaitabunan ng iti ancestor ko, kat naperdi. Ket iti pader na dinadael iti apoy. Ket tano umababat istorya, ito'y nga pinalubusan ni King Artaxerxes ni Nehemiah nga mapanda e rebuild aji wall of Jerusalem. But ano ko na ni Nehemiah? He conclude ko na to'y, and because the gracious hand of my God was upon me. Apay pinalubusan da? Adaki ni Apo iti control. So, the brokenness of Israelites. Makita to iti kabsat. Iti broke, nagbasit. Diyak, unay mabasan. The brokenness iti Israelites iti kabsat. They were captivated by Babylonians for 70 years. Oh. Panunutin yung manajay? Slave for 70 years. Nalaka, narigat. Narigat. Parmi pa ng parparigat da. Ayun ti Jeremiah 25:9-11. Kung ano to'y This is na i-prophesy atoy kakabsat. I will summon all the peoples of the north and my servant Nebuchadnezzar, king of Babylon, declares the Lord, and I will bring them against this land and its inhabitants and against all the surrounding nations. I will completely destroy them and make them an object of horror and scorn and an everlasting ruin. Sino tiwi? Bagbaga na to eh. The Israelites. Verse 10, I will banish from them the sounds of joy and gladness, the voice of the bride and the bridegroom, the sound of milestones and the light of the lamp. This whole country will become a desolate wasteland, and these nations will serve the king of Babylon for 70 years. Naipadto kakabsat nga dagiti Israelites, they will be serving the king of Babylon for 70 years. Jeremiah 25:9-11. And then the brokenness, one of the brokenness of the Israelites is the complete destruction and shame. Atoy, the complete destruction and shame. Buo nga city na perdi ken na ibaba in the pay. No sika nga ta, tidadjay, anati mariknam. Isaiah 43:27-28. From the beginning, your ancestors sinned against me, all your leaders broke my laws. That is why I have disgraced your priests and assigned Israel a future of complete destruction and shame. And shame. Kahit ko lang nga i-expound kakabsat, iti daytoy nga prophecy ni Isaiah. Ito ayan ti time na Isaiah kabsat. Ato in padtunang maaramid iti the complete destruction and shame iti Israel ket naaramid iti time ni sino nga prophet? Jeremiah. Jeremiah witness na iti panakadadael iti Israel. Panakadadael iti Jerusalem, iti Judah. He witness everything. Iti panakaperdi iti wall of Jerusalem. Na witness na. That's why he was called the weeping prophet. So nga dati lamentation. So, let's proceed. After the captivity, after the brokenness of Israel, here comes the prophecy that the Israelites will be set free from the hands of Babylon. Isaiah 45:13. I will raise up Cyrus in my righteousness. I will make all his ways straight. He will rebuild my city and set my exiles free. But not for a price or reward, says the Lord Almighty. So, ito ay kakabsat nga makita tayo nga iti panaka-set free iti Israelites is in God's control. Isaiah 44:24-26. This is what the Lord says. Ilagtaw tayo, verse 26. Who carries out the words of his servants and fulfills the predictions of his messengers, who says of Jerusalem, it shall be inhabited of the towns of Judah. They shall be built, and of their ruins I will restore them. Sino ti mang restore? Ni Apo. So despite for all the brokenness you are encountering right now, believe that God is in control. Brokenness is lesser than God's control. Dakdakkel iti control ni Apo ng iti panaka-broken mo. Genesis 50:20, story ni Joseph. Idi inla ko da isuna. Sino makamutoy? Anati ko na idi nakikita da ulit. You intended to harm me. But God intended it for good. So dagita brokenness yu tata. It is not intended to harm you, but God intended it for good. Next. Story of Job. Ano ti brokenness ni Job? Amo tayo, mukha familiar amin kada tayo detoy. Napukaw iti sanikwana, napukaw dagiti anak na. Nagsakit pa'y isuna. Iti nga makita tayo. Iti brokenness nga malala. But then, anak na na, Job 12:10, for the life of every living things is in His hands. Amin nga biyag nga si nga agbiyag-biyag dito'y lubong kat adda ayan ti ima ti apo. So nga napay ko Proverbs 16:9. We can make our plans, but the Lord determines our steps. Yes, we can make our plans. Ngum ni apo isu iti akin igum no ana iti iyagdang tayo. Jeremiah 29:11, the story of Israelites. Isu ato yung kakabsat. Ato yung time, isu ato yung ayan ti panakak slave dan iti Babylonian Empire. Anako na ni apo toy, for I know the plans I have for you. Tani apo amuna ti plano na para ken dagiti Israelita. Ni apo amuna iti plano na para kinka. So nga mamati tayo nga dagiti brokenness tayo. Ada yan ti control ni apo. Control ni apo amin deta. Proverbs 19:21. You can make many plans, but the Lord's purpose will prevail. Ni apo. Kung nagtatay, ni apo lang iti akin control. Iso nga mamati tayo, no daman sagsagabaom tata, patyum nga ni apo, iso timang kon-control. God has a plan and He is in control of everything. So ang kamadanagan, uray pa'y kasla intupak daking ka iti ano di expression da? Nga ano di, sino ti makaisawang? Na itupak iti di Tagalog na? Aje kasla na itupak iti buong mundo kinyak. Kasjay. Nang Tagalog na aje yan, sorry, medyo nakapsot ang gamin Tagalog. So, uray kasano iti kaadu lagiti problema tayo. At dati plano ti Diyos. Adati plano ti Diyos king ka. Mamati ka. Because God, He is in control of everything. Makadwa. Ways to rebuild your wall. The help of God is on your way. Sino mamati? Nga ititulong ti Diyos adatan umay king ka. Nga titulong ti Diyos, it is not late, it is not early, but perfect. So ang kamaradanagan, kakabsat, while we rebuilding our wall, there are hindrances. Adu dagiti hindrances. Nehemiah 2:10. The God of heaven will help us succeed. The God of heaven, ni Apo, iso timang tulong kada tayo, tatno agbalay ki tayo. Sino ti kayat nagbalay ki? Amen. Datan titulong ni Apo. So, hindrances of Israelites. Makita tayo kabsat? Those who are against rebuilding the wall. Dito iti may sanga hindrance. Iti panangipatak derda, iti wall of Jerusalem. Dagiti aga against nga patak derda ulit. Iti wall of Jerusalem. Kunana iti Nehemiah chapter 2 verse 10. But when Sanballat the Horonite and Tobiah the Ammonite heard of my arrival, they were very angry. Makaung-ungot da. Apay, that someone had come who was interested in helping Israel. At iti may sanga hindrance, kakabsat, iti panangipatak derda, iti wall of Jerusalem. Madikayat ni Sanballat ken Tobiah. Apay, because kunada, it is rebelling against the king. But the king, ni King Artaxerxes, kakabsat, ket na inikan na iti permission ni Nehemiah. Ngam dagitoy talaga, no adati bida, ada talaga ti kontrabida. Right? Hanga mabalin, nga awan iti kontrabida no adda ti bida. Always nga adda. Kada tayo kakabsat, addamot iti kontrabita. What are those? Digiti mang hinder. Digiti mang laplapud kada tayo as we build our wall of Jerusalem. Anapay, iti mang laplapud, those who mock or disappoint them. Kastoy, Nehemiah 4:1-13, Sanballat was very angry when he learned that we were rebuilding the wall. He flew into rage and mocked the Jews, saying in front of his friends and the Samaritan army officers, what does this bunch of poor feeble Jews think they're doing? Do they think they can build the wall in a day if they offer enough sacrifice? Look at those charred stones they are pulling out of the rubbish and using again. Tobiah the Ammonite who was at his side said, what they are building, if even a fox climbed up on it, he would break down their wall of stones. Kita nyo ti panang disappoint da. Kundag iti Israelites. Iti panang rebuild da, iti wall of Jerusalem. Kaya da kadbut nga palpas ndeta, iti may sa altaw. Adu, nagiti mang disappoint. Nagiti Israelites. Kastamot kad iti biag iti may sa Kristiyano. Why we rebuilding our wall, there are so many disappointments. Sinudto'y tinakariknan nga tired, nabanog iso nati aminan. You are tired physically. You are tired emotionally. You are tired mentally. You are tired spiritually. Sino ito'y tinakarik natin kasi diya eh? But then, hindrance lang na kita kakabsat. Because hindrance is greater ititulong ti Apo. Because God's help is on your way. Hebrews 13:6. So we say with confidence, the Lord is my helper. I will not be afraid. What can men do to me? The Lord is my helper. So tonight we say with confidence, the Lord is my helper. Hebrews, Exodus 14:21. The story of dividing the sea. Amok nga familiar kada tayo dito yung kakabsat. Dividing the Red Sea. Exodus 14. Sino tinangtulong kadakwada? Ni Apo. Then Moses raised his hand over the sea, and the Lord opened up a path through the water with a strong east wind. The wind blew that night, turning the seabed into dry land. Ititulong ni Apo, nala daw ba? Ito'y haan. Titulong ni Apo, nasa pa ba? Haan. But it's perfect. Perfect. God's timing is always perfect. So the help of God is always in perfect time. Psalms 121 verses 1 to 3. I lift my eyes to the hills. Where does my help come from? Sagsasotoy, David. My help comes from the Lord, the maker of heaven and the earth. He will not let you stumble and fall. The one who watches over you will not sleep. Data, iti helper tayo kakabsat. Iti mang tultulong kada tayo. No, ada iti mang laplapod tayo kada tayo nga mang build iti wall of Jerusalem tayo. Our help comes from the Lord. He will not let you stumble and fall. And He will watch over you. He will not be asleep. Ang ama maturo di Diyos. Psalms 118 verse 7. The Lord is with me. He is my helper. I will look in triumph on my enemies. So kung naman, kanta kaabay mo, the Lord is with me. He is my helper. Amen. Hanatay lang at tulungan ti Apo. Anapay, I will look in triumph on my enemy. Di panangtod ni Apo iti tulong kada tayo, ikan na tayo iti victory. So God will help us in every way. Trust Him. Amin nga banag, usaran ni Apo, tatno tulungan na tayo. So nga, agtalag tayo lang, kenkwana. Okay. Last, pray to God. Last way to rebuild your wall, pray to God. Nehemiah chapter 4 verse 8 to 9. Yes, last pointer. Yes, tanda ni Malpas. Giti excited. Nehemiah 4, 8 to 9. Kuna na to'y, but we prayed to God. We prayed to God. Basahin yung tulatan ti chapter 4, verse 8 to 9. Ngumada ko na na to'y, but we prayed to God. So the Israelites were in danger from the incoming attack of their enemy. The Israelites were in danger from the incoming attacks of his enemy. Nehemiah prayed that time. Nehemiah 4:12-14, kuna na to'y, then the Jews who lived near them came and told us 10 times over. Boom. Sino to iti madina kayat iti maulit paulit-ulit nga mabagbagaan. Dati kasi jay, right? Ngum itoy the Jews who lived near them came and told us 10 times mabinsa nga pulo da nga ikulit-kulit nga ibaga nga kunada. Wherever you turn, they will attack us. Anyaman iti papanam. Dagiti kalaban tayo, atakyan da tayo. Sino dagitoy? The Ammonite, ni Sanbalat, kini Tobia, isuda iti kontrabida, kanda ito nga time. But kuna ni Nehemiah. Therefore, I stationed some of the people behind the lowest points of the wall at the exposed places, posting them by families with their swords, spears, and bows. After I looked things over, I stood up and said to the nobles, the officials, and the rest of the people, don't be afraid of them. Remember the Lord who is great and awesome, and fight for your brothers, your sons, and your daughters, and your wives, and your homes. Remember the Lord who is great and awesome. God is greater than our enemies. Dakdakkel ti Dios ngem dagita nga paka brokenan dagita paka mang lapped ken dagita enemy tayo. Dakdakkel ti Dios. Nehemiah 4:15. When our enemies heard that we knew of their plans and that God frustrated them, we all returned to our work on the wall. So hanga natuloy iti panangatak, dagiti kontrabida, iti panangipatak derda, panang rebuilda iti wall of Jerusalem. Apay, tadakdakkel ti Dios nga kampida. So nga kada tayo, dakdakkel ti Dios nga kampi tayo. So, frustrations over prayer. Psalms 118 verse 6. But in my distress, I cried out to the Lord. Yes, I prayed to my God for help. He heard me from his sanctuary. My cry reached his ears. Dagiti kararag tayo kini Apo, dumandanon itilapayag na. Mangmangeg ti Dios, dagiti kararag tayo. So ngahang kayo maawanan tinamnama. Daniel 6:10. Nati frustration ni Daniel ito, the story of Daniel. Aji time nga nai approvean iti decree nga amin nga agdayaw kini King Nebuchadnezzar ket maitapwak jay Dance of Lions. Kat ana iti inubra ni Daniel, iti naramid nato. Now, when Daniel learned the decree had been published, he went home to his upstairs room where the windows opened toward Jerusalem. 3 times a day, he got down on his knees and prayed, giving thanks to his God just as he had done before. So, anati naging resulta na. Anati resulta na after nga nagkararag, prinotektaran ti Diyos isuna. So, Isaiah 38:1-2. Story of Hezekiah. Sino mga mudtoy? Aji time nga matay isunan. Isaiah 38:1-2. And the verse 2, verse 1. In those days, Hezekiah became ill and was at the point of death. The prophet Isaiah, son of Amos, went to him and said, "This is what the Lord says, put your house in order because you are going to die. You will not recover." Nagmayat nga tanno, adi maamwam aya. Nagtimog ti apo, matay katatan, agsagana kan. Kanom ti kayat mo amin nga kayat mga kanunan. But, verse 2, Hezekiah turned his face to the wall and prayed to the Lord. Ana ti resulta na nadagdagan pay ititawen ti panagbiag na. Kita nyo? The power of prayer. Dakdakkel ti panagkararag ngem dagiti frustrations tayo. Dagiti pakafrustratan tayo. Dakdakkel ti kararag. Dagiti paka riribukan tayo. Dakdakkel iti kararag. Maaramidan ti kararag. So God is greater than your brokenness. Dakdakkel ti Diyos ngam iti panaka-broken mo. Iti may isa nga Kristiyano kasla kintsugi. Kintsugi. First, kintsugi. What does it mean? It means the Japanese art of repairing broken pottery. Kintsugi. And it means to join with gold. Dagiti, pakabrokenan tayo, it represents the gold. Kita nyo, tilangana no, join with gold, no maaramid. No ma-broken, iti... Ang agpakita diya red na. Aji pinggan ko ma, no ma-broken, no mabitak, anati ar-arami doon tayo. Diba? Awa na, magsir-sirbinan, balenggan. Iti flower vase. Ah, magayang mabitak doon ito. Ang joke lang, ang kubit-bitagan ako, Pastor. Nagiti flower vase. Nagiti baso. Diba no, mabitak da, baga tayo? Awan ser-serbina. But then, we are like kintsugi in Japanese art. Ni Apo, i-repair na tayo. God allow us to be broken. That so that He can mold us to the... So He can mold you into the best version of you. Ni Apo i-allow na nga ma-broken tayo tatno ma-imold na tayo iti best version nga sika. So dawatak nga tumakdar iti bawat na isa. So may I ask the worship team. If you feel broken tonight, no ado dagiti paka broken nam tatangarabi. You are free to rebuild your wall.
Praise.
You are free to come
praise
in front and rebuild your wall. You know yourself tonight. Amok nga itinaldaw aldaw kapanakbihag iti mesa Kristiyano. Adda dagiti problema. Adda dagiti sagsagabaan tayo. Adda iti saksakitan tayo. Adda dagiti pakariribukan tayo. The reason why. Reason why nga dati katata. Because we want you to rebuild your wall that God provide for you.
Higit sa aking isipin ay kaya mong gawin.
If you feel broken, you are free to come in front. And let's, we will pray for you. Hallelujah, Jesus. Hallelujah. Hallelujah, Jesus.
Higit sa aking isipin ay kaya mong gawin. Bawat araw ko ay hawak mo. Di mangangamba sa piling mo.